hard to start your business and are working even harder to make it successful. That's when it's most important to have a community bank and a local banker in your corner. This is Eric Clark from Select Bank and Trust. Our team of local bankers care about you, our customer, and the communities in which we all live and serve together. As the business and economic conditions of 2020 threw you many curveballs, our team at Select Bank and Trust remains steadfast in being responsive to your ever-changing needs. In 2021, choose Select Bank and Trust. Bank local, bank select, member FDIC.
There's no better time to drive away with a quality pre-owned car, truck, or SUV from Greenville Auto World. Greenville Auto World is your authorized rough country dealer. We specialize in lift and leveling kits, along with custom wheel packages. Whether you're looking for ground clearance or enhancing the appearance of your vehicle, trust our team for your off-road experience. Greenville Auto World, 3840 South Charles Boulevard, across from Hardee's at Bell's Fork, or online at greenvilleautoworld.net.
Wait up. Papa John's has a new stuffed crust? Oh, we did it. We did it. All our tweets, DMs, and carrier pigeons worked! This ain't just stuffed crust. This is Papa John's crust. Stuffed.
Hey, Pirate fans, order the new Epic Stuffed Crust One-Topping Pizza for only $12. The new Epic Stuffed Crust Pizza is the MVP move for game day or any day. Place your order online at PapaJohns.com and sign up for Papa Rewards. Papa John's, the official pizza of the ECU Pirates. Looking for a professional to take care of your commercial properties? Gatlinburg Lawns is here for you because customer service is number one. Gatlinburg Lawns specializes in eco-friendly landscaping, landscaping design, mulch, hedging, sod installation, pine straw, tree planting, and much more. If you need landscaping help for your commercial property, call Gatlinburg Lawns today for a free quote at 252-253-5450.
Gatlinburg Lawns, we make it pretty.
This is Pirate Radio, WGHB Farmville, 1250 and 92.7 FM Greenville, WDLX Washington, 930 and 104.1 FM Washington. You're listening to Hour 3 of Pirate Radio Live. Do you need custom t-shirts, apparel, or promotional items for your business, organization, or event? Keep it local. Print it local with University Sportswear. Contact them today at universitysportswearenc.com. Now, back to the show.
Welcome back. Quality Equipment is your full-service John Deere dealer with 28 locations to serve you. Quality Equipment is open in Winterville next to Sam's Club, or visit qualityequip.com to find the location near you. Now, let's head back in to Pirate Radio Live. Here is your host, Clip Rock.
All right, big hour three here on this Tuesday edition of Pirate Radio Live, as we will get you set for the 2021 Greenville Regional. ECU welcoming in Norfolk State, Charlotte, and Maryland. The action begins on Friday. We are your Greenville Regional headquarters from now until the action begins on Friday. And Troy D will talk about it with a couple guests coming up this hour. Ryan Robinson and Steven Igo set to join us.
Indeed.
Nothing to add.
Well, I was waiting for you to ask how I'm doing.
How are you doing?
This is the Mondayest Tuesday.
And you're not even going to answer me?
Of the year, Clip. So I'm very confused today. I was operating all day thinking it's Monday. It's actually Tuesday. But we'll go to bed soon. Tonight we wake up, it'll be Wednesday. And we'll almost be closer to Friday with the regional. And since it's an early game, we're really only like a day away if you think about it that way.
All right. Thank you for explaining that to me. Yeah.
Time's flying.
First pitch set for like 10 minutes from now.
Welcome back. Man, what a big show. What a busy show. What a busy week.
Thanks. I've been here for 2 hours.
I know. I've been listening. Been working in my office. Dialed in, baby.
All right. Double R and Igo coming up.
So here's the deal.
Booty bag coming up.
Yeah. So we got Ron Robinson with ECU Athletics coming up. A lot of people, I have a lot of questions about tickets still. I know they put out releases, but look, I'm getting calls and questions and texts like I'm the ticket office. So we're going to go to ECU, let them answer the questions about it. There's still some, I don't want to say confusion, but a lot of people, you know, people live in a bubble. They don't know. They're not paying attention to every release that goes out. So we'll dumb it down for folks. If you haven't gotten tickets, what you can do to get tickets and what the protocols will be, if any, going into the weekend, parking, all that stuff. So we'll ask a lot of the logistical stuff with Ron Robinson from ECU Athletics coming up, and then we'll talk with Igo about the on-field stuff.
Drop your questions if you have one on Facebook Live. We are rolling there, or on Twitter, and we'll pass your question along to Ryan Robinson.
Yeah.
All right, let's get a break in. We'll come back and have a big hour three of Pirate Radio Live. It's on the way. We're back with you right after this. Weekends are made for AJ McMurphy's. Start your Sunday fun day at AJ's. AJ's is now serving brunch from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. and a build-your-own Bloody Mary bar. Enjoy your weekend with live music on Friday night and Saturday night with no cover charge. And you can catch all of the MLB and ECU baseball action on AJ's TVs. See you this weekend at AJ McMurphy's, Turnberry Square at Bell's Fork, and on Facebook, Instagram, and Snapchat. Hey Pirate fans, it's time to get that yard done right with the new John Deere mower from Quality Equipment. Our premium lawn care lineup is what every homeowner needs this spring. A John Deere will change the way you mow with easy-to-use attachments, effortless steering, and intuitive controls. Right now, save up to $700 on X300, X500, and X700 series mowers. Learn more at qualityequip.com and get quality done right. Offer ends 10/29/21. Some restrictions apply. See dealer for details.
Okay, let's just try not to embarrass ourselves and everything will be fine.
Yeah, sure, totally. Is that a Pepsi Wild Cherry?
Oh, no. Please, not here. Not here.
Too late.
You know something, Steve? Flavor Mania is about to run wild.
Oh, not Flavor Mania.
Pepsi Wild Cherry is about to drop a flavor suplex right into your pie hole. It's going to hit your taste buds with a top rope elbow of flavor. It's going to be delicious. It's going to be refreshing. It's going to throw your wild cherry loving brain right through the announcer's table.
Oh, I can't take you anywhere.
Flavor Mania doesn't need your permission, Steve, because the world knows that nothing is going to get between Pepsi Wild Cherry and that flavor championship belt. Are you ready to get wild?
Oh, please don't.
Come on, Steve. I said, are you ready to get wild?
Seriously, does this always have to happen when you drink Pepsi Wild Cherry?
You better believe it, brother.
Pepsi Wild Cherry, now available in zero sugar. That's what I like.
This is Martin Truex Jr., and as a NASCAR Cup Series champion, I love one-stop shopping. When I need fresh tires or fuel during a race, my pit crew takes care of everything. Off the track, I have an auto owner's independent agent. They handle all my insurance in one place. Car, home, life, and business. Get your own pit crew and find a local agency with auto owner's insurance.
This is Brian Smith with Town Insurance in Greenville. Call me today at 756-8300. Go Pirates!
Hey Pirate Nation, this is Sam Jones, and we're opening here to serve you with some of the best whole hog barbecue, chicken, turkey, ribs, and homemade sides every day for lunch and dinner. There are three easy ways to enjoy Sam Jones barbecue. Swing by our drive-thru window or try one of our two curbside takeout options by calling in your order at 689-6997 or ordering online at samjonesbbq.com. We love Eastern North Carolina, and we invite you to come by and enjoy some great tasting Sam Jones barbecue today.
Hi, I'm Annalie Newhoff.
And I'm Rob Campbell.
And we are with CopyPro. We have been locally owned and operated here in Eastern North Carolina for almost 50 years. CopyPro is the leader in office technology.
Does your business struggle with keeping printing costs low or producing professional documents? Here at CopyPro, total customer satisfaction is our number one priority.
We have a variety of solutions to help reduce your printing expenses and make your business more productive. Call us today at 1-800-682-6558 or online at copypro.net.
CopyPro, we are the professional office systems people.
There's no better time to drive away with a quality pre-owned car, truck, or SUV from Greenville Auto World. Greenville Auto World is your authorized rough country dealer. We specialize in lift and leveling kits, along with custom wheel packages. Whether you're looking for ground clearance or enhancing the appearance of your vehicle, trust our team for your off-road experience. Greenville Auto World, 3840 South Charles Boulevard, across from Hardee's at Bell's Fork, or online at greenvilleautoworld.net.
This is assistant football coach Drew Dudzik, and you're listening to Pirate Radio, the voice of the Pirate Nation.
You're listening to Hour 3 of Pirate Radio Live. Do you need custom t-shirts, apparel, or promotional items for your business, organization, or event? Keep it local. Print it local with University Sportswear. Contact them today at universitysportswearenc.com. Now, back to the show.
Welcome back. At Angel Oak, they continue to make customer service a number one priority. A local mortgage advisor is the key to your transaction success. The combination of their local team's experience and Angel Oak's wide offerings of products from standard conventional government and portfolio loans has something for every financial situation. For more information, call Talbot Green, Joanne Weir, or Wanda Hager at 751-2060. Now let's head back in to Pirate Radio Live. Here is your host, Clip Rock.
Back with you on Pirate Radio Live here on a Tuesday. Stephen Igo, Hoist the Color, is going to join us a little later on this hour, and we'll make you a winner. Open up the booty bag coming up on today's program. But right now, we'll head out to the Fixed NC Live line and talk to Double R, Ryan Robinson, who's fired up for some ECU baseball coming up this weekend. Ryan, how you doing, man?
What's going on, fellas? How we doing?
Doing good. Doing great. Great to have you with us today, Ron. Big weekend in Greenville coming up with the regionals. Busy weekend in Greenville. Not the only thing going on. I understand. I think high school graduation is going on in Minji's this weekend. Next door, you have former President Trump going to be in Greenville at the convention center, giving his first basically public speech since leaving office. So you got a lot of events going on at the same time. Greenville's going to be a hot spot come Saturday and this weekend. But let's talk about the event you're most responsible for, and that's the regional here with the NCAA. Ron, first of all, is East Carolina, are we sold out of tickets?
No, we're not. We're at about 3,200 seats right now sold, and basically you can't buy one right now because what we'll do is we turn it off, and then tomorrow morning at 9 a.m., all session tickets will go on to the general public. So I would say, Troy, we're probably looking at about 600 or 700 more that we can sell, you know, because each team will get 200. So that kind of takes that allotment away. But when we sold, I think we probably sold 800 tickets today, which is incredible. But we will have all session tickets will go on sale in the next 2 days, beginning at 9 a.m., you can go to ecupirates.com or call 252-737-4500. And then whatever tickets we have left on Friday, that is when single session tickets will go on sale at 11 a.m. I would not wait till Friday. If you haven't got your tickets, I get out there and purchase them tomorrow morning. And if you don't have a hotel room, good luck. You probably might need to stay in Raleigh. I understand. The hotel rooms are, Clip Rock, do you have room for your place?
I could house three or four.
You could VRBO somebody, Clip.
Yeah. VRBO. I don't know the Greenville housing scene, but I was told today that hotel rooms are very scarce.
At a premium, I'm sure. Ryan, first of all, the tickets were opened up, first of all, to Pirate Club members, season ticket holders. Kind of disappointed that the Pirate Club folks weren't able to go ahead and just sell this out, that it never had to go to the general public. But there are, as you said, 3,200 seats sold, got about another, what'd you say, 700-800 left to be able to sell?
About 600 or 700 to sell. I think in the past we have went to Wednesday. It's just, tomorrow we will sell, like I said, we sold 700-800 tickets today. Coming off Memorial Day weekend, I think a lot of it, Troy, is people, you know, they're getting back to work, they're making the purchase. Our phones have been lighting up today. I think one of the things that's been pretty cool, and this is a credit to Coach Godwin, our baseball program, you know, we've had a lot of people join the Pirate Club today. And, you know, it allows them to purchase tickets. So I think that's been cool from that standpoint. I just took a call from somebody that made a $1,000 donation. They're going to sit in kind of the bleachers. So, that's been a cool aspect. I think, obviously, the later you go in the week, you're probably going to be in the jungle when you're starting getting to, Wednesday and Thursday. I think we still have some seats where you'll be able to sit in the bleachers. But I get on there tomorrow, I have a call, or get online and make a purchase because it's going to be packed. I know how Pirate Nation is.
Yeah. Ryan, Ron Robinson from EC Athletics joining us. Ron, how are you guys handling parking as far as parking passes for those that are looking for them? And also, if you have a bleacher ticket, will you be able to go to the jungle? And if you have a jungle ticket, will you be able to walk, you know, through the grandstand or, at least, I guess, go to the concession area up there? How will you be handling the jungle versus the stadium seating?
It's a great question, Troy. You will, It'll be just like actually we did this year and just like we've done for the regional. If you're in the jungle, you can't go into the grandstands. You can still go to the concessions around. And if you're in the grandstands, you cannot go to the jungle. And really, it's the only way to determine them. We have kind of a number that we like in the jungle and a number in the grandstand. So it's very helpful for everybody to do it that way. I think we'll have a packed house, especially in the jungle. I don't think the noon start is going to hurt in any way. I think fans will be fired up. You know, our parking lots will open, I think, 3 hours ahead of time. So I'm sure there'll be some people in the jungle at 9 a.m. ready to roll. And then the gates will open, I think it's an hour before the game. So it's going to be an exciting week. I know we'll have plenty of concessions out in the jungle. Obviously, we've got our concessions for the grandstands as well. I think it's a great week. You know, I'm looking forward to watching the Pirates play. But, you know, at 6 o'clock, you got Maryland versus Charlotte. Another good game. I think we'll see some good crowds for those games as well.
And what about the parking run?
Parking, you can buy parking passes online.
Okay.
Until they're sold out. And then, obviously, the general parking will be the Belk. But I haven't looked, but I think there's probably not many Clarksville players, but I think you can get them in the premium. And I will tell you, Troy, I mean, the whole north side of Menchie is going to be full with high school graduations. Obviously, recruiting starts this week for our coaches. So I know Coach Houston on Sunday has got, somebody told me, 200 or 300 players coming in. So it's going to be a busy weekend, but that's cool. That's what makes it great. We're back open for business.
We're back, baby. We're back.
We're back. We're open for business. So I'm looking forward to it. Appreciate your all's coverage of it. And we'll be ready to roll come Friday at noon, but there's still a lot of work to be done over the next couple of days to make sure everybody's taken care of and we can all sit down, enjoy. Hey, and masks aren't required. If you feel like you need to wear one, please do. We want to be safe. But we will, we're looking forward to a loud environment. And really, Troy, if you look at it, I mean, it's the first time probably since, last baseball game before the pandemic hit that we're going to have really a full Clarksville Stadium.
Yeah, definitely.
Ryan, a couple of Facebook Live questions here. One, will folding chairs be allowed in the jungle if you have jungle tickets?
Yeah, you can bring your own chairs. I mean, that's just like in the past. I hope I'm not speaking out of turn on that, but I imagine you are, because we have cleared all the regular seats we have cleared out of the jungle and of right field. So there's no more assigned seats that we had to do following state guidelines.
And this question regarding a super regional, as we look ahead, Steve asking, is the super regional ticket application only applicable if Greenville were to host, or is that being used for any away team seat allocation in Nashville should the Pirates go to Vanderbilt? It's a long question.
Well, I don't like looking ahead, but I don't think Coach Collins listening to the radio. But the first part of that question is, yes, that was just for the Greenville regional clip. And then for Nashville, you know, let's say that happens. You know, Danny does not have a big stadium. So there will be a limited amount of tickets. And obviously we'll do that through the Pirate Club and the priority. But, you know, I think people that know the Vanderbilt Stadium, I don't think it's as large as ours at all. So that'll be a tough ticket, but we'll obviously do everything we can to get as many Pirates there as possible. But obviously right now our focus is on Norfolk State at 12:01 first pitch.
Ryan, I got a couple questions. These are good questions too, some similar, about people that have ordered tickets or pre-ordered tickets, when they will get them and how they will get them. Now, I know you guys, talking with you in the past, you're getting away from paper tickets. You guys are probably going to go mobile or email tickets or print at home. Yeah. I assume that will be the case with this, so people need to be aware of that. When will they be notified? When will they be able to get their tickets? Will it be as early as tomorrow?
Yes, as early as tomorrow. And I'll tell you what's happening right now. So we cut off where you can purchase tickets. So now for the next 5 or 6 hours, you will have our ticket people with Pirate Club that will be allocating tickets. We'll kind of be going through and making sure every ticket is allocated to the right spot. Because if you all remember, we kind of reverted back to 2020 season tickets. Because in 2021, we had some people in chair bags that we had to move just because of social distancing. So we'll spend the next 5 or 6 hours allocating tickets, and then as early as tomorrow, they'll be receiving those via email, which, you know, they can be printed home.
All right, John wants to go off the board without a, not a baseball question, but a football question. How are ticket sales going for East Carolina and the App State game in Charlotte for the season opener?
Well, first, the App State game is going really well. We've actually called them and got some additional tickets. I think with the App State game, like we had an initial surge where we basically sold out of our club seats, and then we'll begin that allocation process in mid-June. So there might be some people that bought club seats that will get, you know, a section over. They're going really well. I mean, I don't have a number. I think I want to say about 2,900, 3,000. I think with football season tickets, you know, I'm looking forward to this week. At some point, we got to circle back, and we got to continue to push football season tickets. We're at a decent number. I think we're at about 11,500. That number, we've just got to do everything we can to get that number towards 14,000. You and I have talked about this, Troy. You know, for order for us, when people say we're going to have a packed house for South Carolina, we've got to sell more season tickets. It's hard to sell that many single game tickets. So we've got a lot of work to do on that front. We've talked internally about some different stuff we want to do over the summer. I'm confident we're going to have a really good summer. We've had a really good Pirate Club year, and I think that's going to continue this summer, especially now that we can get back on the road. I know John is looking forward to getting on the road, seeing donors. I took Coach Houston down to Wilmington last week, and we met with 16 donors, and very supportive. So we're trying to do whatever we can for Coach Houston, the football program as well, as we kind of build this. But right now, this week is baseball, and then, you know, hopefully baseball is another 3 weeks, and then we'll kind of turn our focus to football season tickets.
Ryan, good stuff. Anything else you want folks to know about that maybe we might have missed, especially concerning this weekend, or did we cover it all?
I think we covered it all. I think the main thing is, you know, just wear your purple and gold, and what a great opportunity for us to kind of show people in the city and across the country kind of what Pirate Nation is all about. You know, these games will be on the ESPN platforms, so this is a great opportunity for us to show what Pirate Nation is all about, but also, you know, what Cliff Godwin and these young men are building here right now. It's going to be a special weekend. Let's hope the rain stays away, and let's have some fun.
And I want to mention this to you. You kind of said this at the beginning, because there'll be a lot of folks on campus. This may be their first ECU event in a year and a half since the pandemic kind of started. So this may be the return of a lot of Pirate fans for the first time on campus. You said if someone wants to wear a mask, they can, but there will be no mask requirement, correct?
No mask requirement, but feel free to wear a mask. You know, we still wear them indoors here at the Pirate Club. So let's just have fun. I mean, hey, listen, there's going to be a lot of people out in the jungle. Let's be courteous. I think the main thing, we will enforce some parking at the jungle where everything's got to be in your parking spot. We will have a packed jungle parking lot. We can't allow people to park and then put their grills and other stuff in another parking spot. So let's just all be good Pirate neighbors, and let's show the country what we're all about.
All right, Ryan, good stuff. Thanks for your time. We'll see you out there Friday.
All right, guys. You take care.
All right, Ryan Robinson with ECU Athletics with the latest. A lot of good information there, Clip. So I think that answered a lot of questions, not just ours, but a lot of listeners' questions too.
Yeah, good stuff from Double R. Big weekend, so, and like you said, I mean, a lot of people returning to the athletic complexes of East Carolina for the first time in a really long time.
This will be the first kind of big show, so to speak, since all this stuff has started to die down as far as the pandemic. The 3,200 tickets sold is a big takeaway for ECU. They've got about another 600-700, he said, that they have available. Those will go on sale tomorrow to the general public. Session only tickets, and I believe you can get those, I believe it's $60, you can get a session only ticket for all the games for the jungle. So that's your cheapest price point. If you're waiting to buy single game tickets to try and save money, this is just my suggestion. You can take it or leave it. If you wait, I think you're going to be shut out. I would go ahead and buy the session only ticket and make sure. And maybe it's some tickets you don't need with that, or maybe you can't go to the other games in Maryland and all that stuff. Better to have it, not need it, than need it, not have it. Yeah. Is what I like to say, Clip. And I think they'll sell out within another day or two now that they're open to the general public. And I don't think I would be stunned if single game tickets are even available come Friday.
Pirates in Norfolk State, game one, noon on Friday. That's our Bud Light EC Report brought to you by Bud Light. It reminds Pirate fans to always stay in the game and drink responsibly. Bud Light, the official beer of the ECU Pirates and proudly distributed by Carolina Eagle Distributing since 1989. Let's take a break, and as we go to timeout, let's make somebody a winner on this Tuesday.
Booty, 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 booty everywhere. Booty, 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 booty everywhere.
All right, it is June the 1st, Troy D. That means everyone is eligible. You can win one time a month.
It's a new month, Cliff.
Yes, the slate is clear. Ready to go.
We're like 30 days away from half the year being over.
That we are. 317-1250. Shirley, what are we giving away today?
How about a shrimp taco lunch, courtesy of Chico's?
Shrimp taco. Sounds good.
Shrimp taco.
Shrimp it up.
Shrimply delicious.
317-1250. What caller are we looking for?
I'm going to go with caller number 10.
Scheduled to be at Chico's for lunch tomorrow, on a side note. Might get the shrimp taco lunch special.
You can win one right now. 317-1250. We're back with more. Steven Igo joins us on the other side. We're back after this.
From Brownwood Buick GMC Truck. We've been serving the Pirate Nation in Eastern North Carolina for 83 years. We have four brands, three generations, two showrooms, and one goal, to make sure you leave a happy customer.
This month at Brownwood, get a 2021 Sierra 1500 and save over $5,000 or 0% for 72 months. As always, Brownwood is the home of the lifetime powertrain warranty.
We're located on Greenville Boulevard next to the Convention Center, or shop us online at brownwoodauto.com.
Hey, Troy D here with my good friend Kelvin Rawls from Pest Tech. Kelvin, I just want to thank you and Chris and all the great folks at Pest Tech for such awesome service. You totally eliminated the mosquitoes in my backyard, plus the fire ant problem I was having in the yard.
Hey, you're certainly welcome, Troy. I have heard the same thing from all of our customers through the year of COVID. With everyone being home, they want to enjoy the outside and being mosquito, fire ant, and pest free.
Enjoy all your property from the kitchen to the curb. Visit PestTechOfGreenville.com today for complete service.
I can't think of anyone who doesn't love a clean car, but how often do you actually go to the car wash? Does it take too long, or maybe it's just not a very nice place? Tommy's Express changes everything. Our wash is bright, inviting, clean, and fast.
I love the flat conveyor belt. So easy to pull onto, much smoother ride, and safer for my car.
And when you join Tommy Club, you can wash as often as you like for one low monthly price.
I save money and time.
We're Tommy's Express.
Tommy's Express Wash, now open on the corner of Greenville Boulevard and Red Banks Road. In Greenville.
At U.S. Cellular, we see our customers as more than just customers. They're neighbors. When you switch to U.S. Cellular, you can get the new Samsung Galaxy S21 5G for free with no hidden requirements. As a neighbor, you deserve it. U.S. Cellular, America's locally grown wireless. Terms apply. See uscellular.com for details.
This is Brandon Tate, owner and operator of Atlantic Wireless, an authorized agent for U.S. Cellular since 1997. Visit AtlanticWireless.com to find the store near you. We go beyond the call.
Guess what, Greenville? Calzones are back. Community Calzone is the only restaurant in town specializing in calzones. Choose from over 50 different calzones, or you design your own with unlimited options, including vegetarian. Community Calzone also features wings, huge salads, and more. Plus, they deliver to almost everywhere in Pitt County. Located on Greenville Boulevard next to Ashley Furniture Warehouse, they're open for lunch, dinner, and late night for dine-in, pickup, or delivery. It's Community Calzone.
If you have family coming over this summer, the last thing you want is your air conditioning to not keep the house cool. Face it, the only thing worse than an irritable mother-in-law is a sweaty mother-in-law. So call Delcor to get ready for summer. For a limited time, put no money down and get 12 months same as cash when replacing an HVAC system. Keep your mother-in-law cool. Everybody will thank you. Go to DelcorInc.com or call 252-321-8868. Delcor, the service professionals.
This is James Greenleaf, the general manager of Delcor Heat and Coolant and Plumbing. If you've been holding off on replacing your AC unit, I urge you to make that decision now. The factories have warned all their dealers that HVAC equipment delays will get worse as demand exceeds production capabilities this summer. Don't wait until the peak of the summer heat to get your equipment replaced. Let's get your home ready now. We have great financing options available, including same as cash, no interest, and no payments for 12 months. Call Delcor at 321-8868 or visit us at DelcorInc.com. Delcor, the service professionals.
Do you find yourself hungry, but looking for some new and different options? Then the Bodega Market Cafe in Uptown Greenville is for you.
They offer a full-service menu featuring breakfast, lunch, and dinner, also with a variety of unique vegan selections. Dine in or sit outside in their great outdoor dining area. Plus, they're always ready for pickup or delivery. Open 24/7 for your convenience. The Bodega Mark and Cafe, located in Uptown Greenville, across from the BB&T.
Pirate Radio.
It's going to change. I promise you. As I stand here, it will change. Okay, and when it does, that stadium, it's going to be rocking, and heaven help whoever walks in there to play us.
The voice of the Pirate Nation. You're listening to Hour 3 of Pirate Radio Live. Do you need custom t-shirts, apparel, or promotional items for your business, organization, or event? Keep it local. Print it local with University Sportswear. Contact them today at universitysportswearenc.com. Now, back to the show.
Welcome back. When your AC needs repairing or replacing, call on the reliable service professionals of Delcor Heating, Cooling, and Plumbing. Go to DelcorInc.com or give them a call at 321-8868. Delcor, the service professionals in Greenville. And congratulations to Jeff Dover of Greenville. Picked up a shrimp taco lunch courtesy of Chico's. Grab your amigos and head to Chico's. Enjoy your favorites like shrimp tacos, steak and chicken fajitas, burritos, enchiladas, ACP, and more. Plus ice cold cervezas and Chico's famous margaritas are always available. For Mexican food and fun, it's got to be Chico's. Now let's head back in to Pirate Radio Live. Here is your host, Clip Rock.
We all see it. We all see it. It's like that. It's like that commercial.
Dude, who was the winner?
Oh, boy.
Who was the winner, Shirley?
Go ahead and say it, Shirley.
Do we have to?
Yeah.
I was just wondering.
Jeff Dover.
Jeff Dover. Oh. His cousin left.
Who was that?
Leftover.
Oh, wow. He switched it up.
I got you on that one.
Wow.
You thought I was coming with the right hook of Ben?
Yeah.
And I came with the left.
You have gone Ben for 18 years now. Left.
All left right. Over. Proud his cousin.
Of you. Proud of you for that one.
Thank you.
That was good. All right. Our question of the day, Troy D.
What's that?
Who would Coach Dreyfus start Friday for pitching for ECU?
I don't know, man, because you want to save Gavin for a bigger, I hate to say a bigger game, because every game matters. I heard y'all talk about this.
So what's your answer?
Or do you just go ahead and win and move on?
Just give me an answer.
I think I go Gavin just because I want to win.
Oof.
No, maybe I'll save him, all right, for a bigger game, for the championship Sunday. So, but then you're assuming you get there Sunday.
Well, you don't have to save him for
all
Sunday.
All right, who would you start?
I would go Wisenhunt, Williams, and Smith.
All right.
Would be my rotation.
Well, you have seen more of this in person than I have, so I'm going to go with Coach Clip on this one.
No, but there's a lot of answers. In fact, we'll see what Steven Igo has to say about it. Steven, welcome to the show. Who would be Coach Igo's starter on Friday against Norfolk State?
I would probably go with Wisenhunt. I think the goal is to start the regional 2-0. And at that point, I don't see anybody being able to come out of the loser's bracket and beat ECU twice on its home field, back-to-back games. So, to me, I would throw Wisenhunt and then Williams. But, I think you can make an argument for Tyler Smith. I think you can make an argument for a bullpen day. I mean, Norfolk State is probably one of the worst teams in the field, but so was Quinnipiac a couple of years ago, and anybody can beat anybody on a given day. So, the problem is there's no real clear-cut answer because – Williams has been so dominant as the one. Wisenhunt has been good as the two, but you don't really have a set number three pitcher you feel great about at this point. So it's not an easy call one way or the other.
All right, I'm looking at an updated weather forecast. As you guys know, this will change day but as we get closer. But as of right now, Friday, 50% chance of thunderstorms. So that, which means 50% chance of no thunderstorms.
That actually sounds kind of positive.
Right. So, and then Saturday, mostly sunny skies, partly sunny, no storms, high 86, low of 64, and then Sunday 30% chance of storms. So hopefully as the weekend gets closer, maybe it's less and less on Friday. I do like the move for Cliff to play the early game, which hasn't always been the case. I go ahead and get in, because sometimes a lot of these storms do come in the afternoons, it seems like, late afternoon. Go ahead and get your game in, give yourself more rest, assuming you win. You don't have to deal with, if there is a rain delay later that night, you don't have to mess with it. It's not your problem. I really like that move to go ahead and have East Carolina play that first. And you know me, I'm not a big noon time slot guy. I think this is absolutely the right call for this baseball regional.
Yeah, strategically, I just think it makes the most sense. I mean, and you see a lot of teams that are, you know, usual regional hosts that go to this method. It is not ideal for the fans, but I think it makes a lot of sense, competitively speaking, due to the issues you mentioned, the rain. And also, win or lose, you get more time to bounce back. You know, if you turn around, let's say you play that night game and you lose and you get upset, and hell, let's say it gets pushed later into the night due to the weather, but then you have to turn around the next morning and play an elimination game basically right away. So I think playing the early game, as tough as it is on maybe some of the fans to make it, especially those out of town that have to work, I think it makes a lot of sense and strategically sets you up the best way possible, especially if you win that game. Then you can sit there and you can look at the next opponent live and in person and get an in-person scout as well that night. So, and you get more time off your feet. I just think it makes a lot of sense.
Steven, if ECU doesn't win this regional, who has the best shot to do it? Who's ECU's biggest challenge when you look at Charlotte and Maryland?
I think Charlotte has, Charlotte's an interesting team because they started the year kind of balanced. But, you know, as the year has gone on, their pitching, even though they really do have some talented arms, has gotten a little worn out, it looks like, just looking at the numbers. So, to me, Charlotte is more scary offensively. Maryland has some arms that scare me as well. I think their number two or number three starter is a guy that's 6'6 and has a bunch of strikeouts. And, you know, they have some depth on the mound. You know, it's so tough to evaluate Maryland, though, because the Big Ten is never a great conference in baseball, and they only played games in the Big Ten this year, no non-conference games, but they finished the year strong. They won a series at Michigan, which, you know, was the national runner-up the last time they played a college baseball season. They played well against Indiana, which is a very talented team. So I think Maryland's kind of your sneaky pick. A lot of people will look at Charlotte as the, you know, obvious number two seed that has a chance to win. And in that series earlier this season, they gave ECU pretty much everything they could handle for most of those three games, even though the Pirates swept. They got a couple of big bats in their lineup that scare you, that you don't want to make mistakes to. But Maryland also has a guy with 17 home runs. So I think whoever wins that first 2-3 game really will be sitting in a dangerous spot as far as ECU. But, you know, if you're able to save Gavin for that second game, you know, the Pirates have just been dominant this year when he's on the mound, so you have to feel good about it.
Steven Igo joining us on the Fixed NC Live line. Steven, I know coaches and players, they don't want to look ahead. They just want to focus really just on Friday and then whatever's in front of them after that and just try and win this regional. But I'm not a coach or player, so I can look ahead. I want to project. Let's say East Carolina is successful. They win this regional. They move on most likely to face Vanderbilt. Let's say they're successful. How hard is that road to Omaha that the Pirates have to go through on the road to Vanderbilt, because that is one of the absolute top teams in the country and seems to be a tall order?
Yeah, I mean, I'm with you. There was two teams that I did not want to see ECU paired up with as a potential super regional. And one was Arkansas, which is just an incredible team, top to bottom. The other is Vanderbilt. I mean, you're talking about now, if Vanderbilt wins their regional and ECU wins their regional, the Pirates have to go through not only the defending champions of college baseball from the 2019 season, but they have to go through two top five picks in the upcoming MLB draft in Kumar Rocker and Jack Leiter, who anchor Vanderbilt's rotation. I mean, basically, you're facing two big league starters in that series if you're ECU and you get to that point. So, you know, of course, a lot has to happen between now and then, but man, there's not a tougher road to go through outside of maybe Fayetteville, Arkansas, than Vanderbilt. And it's, it's kind of a bummer. You look at the overall super regional pairings, potential super regional pairings, and you'd almost get rather matched up with Tennessee, who's the 3 seed and has a much tougher regional than Vanderbilt. So if ECU would have been the 14 instead of the 13 overall national seed, it might have worked out better. So we'll see, though. I mean, crazy things happen. You know, it could end up being a Maryland-Georgia Tech super regional, and all this talk would be for nothing. But I definitely think it makes up for a tough road if it plays out like the chalk.
Yep.
A couple of non-baseball questions, I go, while we got you here. A guy I don't know if we've talked about a player that has never made it to ECU more than Hadeem C. aka Kadeem Sy. We talked about him 2 years ago when ECU was on his final list and he went to Ole Miss. Now he's in the transfer portal and ECU is in the top. Is it three again, Igo? I saw a picture today, a gift he put out on Twitter with rotating jerseys, and ECU is one of them. So he is loving this attention he's getting inside the transfer portal. Any update on him? I know that you've said in the past that until he actually signs here, you're not going to speculate much. Do you even know when he's going to make an announcement, though?
I don't at this time. I mean, that's the thing. He announced however many weeks ago that he's going to announce the decision last Wednesday, and then Wednesday came and went, and we didn't hear a word from him, and then it was revealed that he had delayed his decision. He had a top four of Minnesota, Clemson, Wake Forest, and ECU, and now it's down to a top three of ECU, Wake Forest, and Clemson. So it makes you wonder, was he going to commit to Minnesota and then was told no? At this point, he just needs to make a decision. I mean, this thing has been dragging on.
I disagree. I say keep it going until, like, the first day of college basketball, and he just shows up at one of the schools. Do it like wrestling or something.
At this point, I'm expecting him to now put out a GIF of his top two.
Yeah.
Next week. He's just going to keep whittling it down. So, you know, maybe it's a good sign that ECU was the first school on his GIF, because I have his tweet set up as an alert on my phone just in case he commits to ECU. You know, it pops up on my phone. So when it popped up originally, it popped up with him in an ECU jersey.
You can do that? I didn't even know that you could put an alert like that. That's pretty cool.
And
that's how Igo gets everything.
Yep. I thought he had committed to East Carolina.
How many alerts do you have on people?
I've got Hadeem C set up currently. I've got ECU Athletics when they tweet.
Mm-hmm.
It comes up. I think ECU Football. And that's about it.
What about Pirate Radio?
I had the old Pirate Radio account. I have yet set up.
Hey, if you get an alert from the old account, let us know.
Yeah, we'd like to get that alert if we're back up and running there.
I'll definitely let you guys know.
Speaking of the transfer portal, what do you think about Steve Rockefort entering the portal, getting picked up by Texas A&M? Now, I believe this is the last original kind of cast member of Joe Dooley, of his original staff, if I'm not mistaken, Igo, that, you know, who's going to have to bring in a new assistant. What are you hearing?
Yeah, so he's the final of the three that Joe Dooley originally hired. And, you know, it was Rafael Chilius and Ken Potasnik, who I've yet to see pop up anywhere since he was, I think, let go.
He went the way of Kenwick Thompson. He kind of disappeared.
He vaporized.
Yeah.
Yeah. Is there proof of life? Send us a picture with him holding today's newspaper. So make sure he's okay.
He's still walking around Greenville somewhere, but we've yet to find Kip Potasnik. So if he's out there, let us know. Maybe he's hanging out with Kenwick Thompson at a bar somewhere. But no, it's, you know, I think this has been the worst a while. I've been hearing about it, honestly, about a month and a half. So I would envision that Joe Dooley has somebody lined up. It was just a matter of Coach Rock needing or waiting for his contract to expire at ECU, and it expired at the end of May. So, this has been the works a while. Joe Dooley's known about it a while. And I think he would want a experienced recruiter, because that's what Rock was. He had great ties to Texas, did a tremendous job bringing in some talent. You look at the current roster, what's coming back, well, what little is coming back, is Coach Rock's recruits, Tristan Newton, Brandon Suggs, Tremont Robinson-White, were all recruited by Coach Rock. So they got to get a recruiter in here who can continue to bring in talent like that.
Igo, recruiting is back for the first time in a very long time. I saw one tweet today. I believe the name is Tyreek McKendall. Says, I will be at ECU football on June the 4th. So probably not a bad week to have some recruits in to show off the East Carolina fan base that are going to be at the Greenville Regional. How many kids do you think, Igo, will be around this weekend for Mike Houston to finally be able to talk to and see in person?
So tomorrow they're having one of their top targets come in, Carter Wyatt from West Brunswick High School, who's a regional recruit who is also visiting Duke, Georgia Tech, and Syracuse this month. You know, a guy that they're very high on, linebacker. And then this weekend they'll have some guys come and go, but Sunday is the big day that it'll be a camp day and their first prospect camp since summer of 2019, so first prospect camp in 2 years, and you're going to have a couple hundred kids on campus practicing and going through drills on that practice field while the Greenville Regional is going on, which is pretty cool. I think that'll make for a pretty cool atmosphere for all those guys to get a taste of how passionate Pirate fans are. You know, not all those kids, of course, are Division I prospects, but they're coming to work out. And then you've got some guys who are Division I prospects that are hoping to earn offers from East Carolina and impress the coaching staff by working out in person. It's just so vital to have those guys in person, to work them out, to learn their coach, you know, how coachable they are, to see how big they are in person, because most times when guys are listed at 6 foot, they're really about 5'10 online. So it's just so vital to get them in person and actually, you know, weigh them, measure them, and then see how they move in person. So
sounds like a combine, Iga, but for ECU rather than NFL scouts. Interesting.
It's basically, yeah, I mean, it's basically a combine. All those kids go to these schools, you know, ECU is hosting a camp, NC State, Wake Forest, Duke, you know, all across the state, they're going to be hosting camps throughout June, and it's an opportunity to get as many of those guys in person as you can see. And then if they show out well, you offer them, you know what you're getting, and you can get them to commit.
Cliff, I just saw the GIF you were talking about earlier on Hadeem C. That is a strong graphic game.
Definitely.
That young man has. Whoever is handling his graphics, that is impressive.
I guess I mean, that would be at UDXG underscore.
Man, that is pretty cool with the ECU full uniform, Clemson full uniform, and Wake Forest full uniform, basketball unis rotating like that. Looks really cool. I mean, I got to say, that's pretty impressive with the logos of each school behind him.
Is he an Adidas guy or a Nike guy? Could come down to that, Iga.
Yeah, I mean, this is like the third final schools graphic he's included East Carolina on.
I go sick of this guy.
Maybe he's just going to be a graphic artist. That's why he wants to keep doing this.
At this point, I'm convinced he's just ghosting everybody. He's not even a real person. So.
Lucas Thompson, 2.0.
Yeah. Lucas Thompson, the most talked about football recruit never to come to ECU.
Yeah, this guy is trying to take over from basketball.
Yeah, he could be the most talked about basketball recruit never to come.
Yeah.
Well, hopefully he'll be here.
Steven, thanks for joining us, man. We'll catch up with you later on in the week.
All right, guys. Y'all have a good one.
All right, go breaking down the Greenville Regional over at Hoist the Colors. Had a Norfolk State back breakdown earlier today if you want to know Friday's opponent. All right, let's get our final break in. We'll come back. You're ready to wrap things up here on a Tuesday edition of Pirate Radio Live.
And you don't have to wait till Friday for baseball in Greenville, sports fans. You want to get an early jump on the weekend. Tonight, hot action at Elm Street Park. And what do you say? You can't make it there, Clip? Are you too busy? You maybe want to stay home and watch the Hurricanes game? Don't worry. Broadcasting live, making his debut on the Elm Street Park Network, Chandler Honeycutt.
Salute, brother.
Working side by side with yours truly tonight from Elm Street Stalling Stadium.
Can't wait.
Be our first time working together in a capacity like that.
That's right.
Where we have to be like professional.
Sort of, kind of.
Can't be joking around all the time. It's Little League, buddy. Take it serious.
Greenville, especially Greenville.
Yeah,
Little League.
It's big business.
They take it seriously out there. And I wish I had that kind of atmosphere when I was growing up. Every game that I've been to out there, I tell the person that I'm with, I'm like, I would, you know, kill to have.
We were sitting together at a game earlier this year.
Yeah.
And we were doing faux play-by-play in color,
right?
But we were in. We were doing it as other people. What were we doing?
We were doing it as Rick Smith.
Oh,
we were doing
it
as a different personality.
Yeah, I'd do a little Jim Rome. He'd do a little Jim Rome. We were doing it as characters.
Yeah.
I wonder if we should do that tonight.
Yes. Definitely.
We'll have some grandmothers and aunts and uncles. Probably not.
Get it. Our humor would be lost on some of those folks. I think that would be funny though.
Use this as a test run when you're going to watch the Pirates play Marshall on Facebook later this year.
Yeah.
Watch the game tonight on Facebook as a test run.
Yeah.
Pull it up on your TV.
Mike Hamrick, ahead of his time. A true visionary.
We'll talk about that too when we return. All right. More to go on Pirate Radio Live. We're back after this.
Hey, Pirate Nation, Troy D here. Excited about the NCAA Regional Baseball Weekend in Greenville. And Pirate Radio has a special gift for you. Stop by UBE beginning this Friday at 9 a.m. and get your free shirt while supplies last. It's first come, first serve, and only one shirt per person. Get your regional weekend started right at UBE this Friday at 9 a.m. and pick up your brand new Birdhouse Pirate Radio t-shirt for free, exclusively from Pirate Radio, the voice of the Pirate Nation. And go Pirates!
Hey Pirate fans, this is Cliff Godwin. Summer is here and I want to invite your son to attend Cliff Godwin Youth Camps. We will offer three sessions the weeks of June 28th, July 12th, and July 26th. All camps will be held at Clark LeClair Stadium and campers will get baseball instruction from members of the 2021 ECU baseball team. Campers will also play games and each camp ends with our famous Pirate Slip and Slide. Full day and half day sessions are offered. For more information, visit CliffGodwinBaseballCamp.com. See you there. Go Pirates!
This is Dr. Anthony Scalic from Orthopedics East and Sports Medicine Center of Greenville. We offer a variety of services including arthroscopic surgery, sports medicine, carpal tunnel surgery, general orthopedics, fracture care, total joint replacement, physical therapy, and on-site MRIs. For experienced and professional medical care, visit our office on W.H. Smith Boulevard in Greenville and online at orthoeast.com. Orthopedics East, providing services to ECU and Pitt County Athletics for over 35 years. Go Pirates!
With rates being historically low, now is the best time to buy or refinance your home. This is Talbot Green with Angel Oak Home Loans. Now is the time to take advantage of the opportunity to buy more home or refinance your current mortgage. The combination of our local team's experience and Angel Oak's wide offerings of products from standard conventional, government, and portfolio loans has something for most financial situations. For more information, call Talbot Green, Joanne Weir, or Wanda Hager at 751-2060.
NMLS 1719250 and 685-842. Equal housing lender.
The icy treat that can't be beat is Sparky Snowballs. From big kids to little kids, Sparky Snowballs has been making smiles happen for over 20 years. If you're not in the mood to chill out with a snowball, Sparky's Funnel Cakes and Fried Oreos are a perfect Sparky-licious treat every time. Look for Sparky Snowballs location at the Food Truck Rodeo on the corner of Evans Street and Fire Tower Road, and remember to follow Sparky's on Facebook or visit SparkySnowballs.com.
At U.S. Cellular, we see our customers as more than just customers. They're neighbors. When you switch to U.S. Cellular, you can get the new Samsung Galaxy S21 5G for free with no hidden requirements. As a neighbor, you deserve it. U.S. Cellular, America's locally grown wireless. Terms apply. See uscellular.com for details.
Does the idea of going to your local U.S. Cellular store make you feel a bit uncomfortable? Tired of the hassle of waiting and wearing a mask? Let Toby Williams and his outside sales team take away that worry. They will come right to your home or office and drop your phone off on the porch or at the front desk for you. Saving you time and worry is what the team at Cellular Warehouse is all about. Call Toby today at 252-799-7051 and let them help you with all of your wireless needs. Cellular Warehouse, your local U.S. Cellular authorized agent.
Here with Melissa from ENS Hemp Company. Melissa, tell us how your products and services can help people.
Well, for over 2.5 years, the team at ENS Hemp Company has been helping educate our community on the many benefits of our products. Our customers have seen great success dealing with everything from stress, anxiety, fatigue, pain, and PTSD, just to name a few. You can come in today and our staff can help you find the best products for your needs. You can visit us at Fire Tower Road near Sam Jones Barbecue or ENSHempCompany.com.
This is East Carolina assistant basketball coach Steve Rockford, and you're listening to Pirate Radio, the voice of the Pirate Nation.
You're listening to Hour 3 of Pirate Radio Live. Do you need custom t-shirts, apparel, or promotional items for your business, organization, or event? Keep it local. Print it local with University Sportswear. Contact them today at universitysportswearenc.com. Now, back to the show.
Welcome back. Taking a quick look at your stock market report, the Dow was up 45 points at 34,575. The NASDAQ fell 12 points and closed at 13,736, and the S&P was down 2 at 4,202. That's your Wells Fargo Advisors financial report. For a personal look into investing, call Wells Fargo Advisors today at 756-6900 in Greenville. Wells Fargo Advisors LLC, member SIPC. Now let's head back in to Pirate Radio Live. Here's your host, Cliff Brock.
All right, we talked a lot of baseball today. We talked some hoops. How many days until ECU football kicks off their season against Appalachian State? We're about to find out right now as ring boy Chandler Honeycutt delivers the goods. He is not wearing shorts today.
Oh, my God.
So we got a pants.
Oh, I thought he was
wearing pants. Yeah.
Thank God. Okay.
He's doing pants. No shorts.
There he is.
93?
93 days.
Wow, Troy D.
93 days.
It's
93 days.
I don't want anybody to freak out, but getting a little serious.
Yeah.
Getting a little serious.
Mm-hmm.
ECU and App State will play to open the season in Charlotte.
One of our former coaches used to say, the hay is never in the barn. There's a lot of hay outside the barn we got to get done right
Still
now.
Still a lot of hay.
Yeah.
How about old ADs? The opener against App State. But coming up and then 11th, they'll play at home, the home opener in South Carolina.
Mm.
And then September 18th, ECU goes on the road to face the Marshall Thundering Herd. And we have a kickoff time for that game. It'll be 6 o'clock.
Yeah.
You like that time?
Yeah, I love that time. And it's going to be CBS Sports Network on
Facebook.
Yeah, so
the other day we were saying
CBS Sports Network.
The other day we were saying when CBS Sports Network advertises their game, they should say only on CBS Sports Network.
You're right.
No. Well, in this case, it's on CBS Sports Network on Facebook. There are two qualifiers.
Wow.
To CBS, CBS Sports Network on Facebook.
Yeah,
the game will be on Facebook.
Yeah. Well, you bunch of dummies, I got the idea of watching y'all on Facebook this past year.
Well, Mike Hammer just walked in.
I pay attention to see what goes on in Greenville still, and I love watching Pirate Radio. All them people I used to know, like Butterbean and company. You know all those people that I can't stand.
Mike Hammer,
I didn't know you that then, but if I did, I would have hated you too.
Did you invent the internet, Mike?
You sound like Gomer Pyle from the Andy Griffith
show. Well, if you knew Mike Hamrick, he sounds like Gomer Pyle. Mission accomplished. Look, Chandler getting a little defensive because someone's doing impersonation.
That might be Troy's best impression, actually. Mike Hamrick.
Yeah. All right. Yeah, so the game will be on Facebook.
Yes.
Yeah, like on the Marshall. Like, oh, I guess you got to go to CBS Sports Network.
Right.
Like their channel on Facebook.
Yeah.
Like, or their page on Facebook.
Kind of like. But you said the presentation was just like it would be on TV, right?
Yeah, I looked at it earlier.
It's going to be the same graphics. It's going to be good. It's just, you're just going to have
the same song. Da 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 da, yeah. Da 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 da.
Yeah.
Welcome to Facebook.
Well, I mean, you know what? This could be the future, guys. I mean, you never know. With smart TVs and stuff, we're on Facebook.
Or it could just be Conference USA. And we'll watch games on television from here to the end of time.
I mean, if it's free, that's better than having to pay for it, I'll say.
All right. Glass half full Troy D here. I like it.
Trying to be positive.
There you go. Yeah. All right, Troy, we'll see you later this week.
Sounds good. We'll be here Thursday with you in the hour three.
Shirley Chandler, we'll see you Tuesday. And today's Tuesday.
Wednesday. I told you. This is the Mondayest Tuesday ever, Clip Rock. I got you.
I got through the whole damn show and didn't say that today was Monday. We'll see you Wednesday, 3 o'clock, for an all-new edition of Pirate Radio Live. So long, everybody.
Thanks for listening to Pirate Radio Live, an exclusive presentation of the voice of the Pirate Nation. This is Pirate Radio, WGHB Farmville, 1250 and 92.7 FM Greenville, WDLX Washington.